is showing you how to replace the plates for your Air 7000. Whenever you order them, it will be the C3500 plates, and it comes as a set, so you only need one order for your whole Air 7000 or A7K. Either one, the both units take the same plate. So we'll go ahead and set this off to the side for the time being. And what we'll need to do next is to remove the screws from the unit. There will be six of them on each side. Sometimes your torque driver is torqued too low and it just takes a little muscle power to go through this, so. So, here at work, I have these little nice little cups. Go ahead and put your screws into a little plastic cup, plastic bowl, something off to the side, so that way you don't lose anything by accidentally knocking it off and it getting lost into your carpet. I've had that one happen several times. Now we have removed all of the screws from that area. Go ahead and remove your cover. Then set your cover off to the side. And then once you have your unit open, it'll expose your plates. And there are four screws that you'll have to remove and four nuts. Make sure whenever you take the nut off that you do not lose the washer that is under the nut. It just kind of helps hold the plate down and firm in place. Side note, if you guys open your unit before you order plates, and this PVC board here, if this has any type of fire damage to it, go ahead and tell your sales representative or whoever you're talking to on the phone that you need a fire plate thrown in with your order, and we'll go ahead and throw that in with the order. It wouldn't be an extra charge, it would just be throwing it in with the order. So, just a side note for you guys. So, our first step will be to remove the screws, because if you remove the screws before the nut, it makes it a little bit easier because sometimes those screws are torqued down. So go ahead and remove your screw. All right. So now just, that one kind of came out at an angle, so it was a little more difficult. So now that those are off, all four wires are free, go ahead and select a screwdriver, well, a screwdriver for the nut. So. We'll go ahead and remove both for each plate. It'll be a little bit more difficult because we have put a conformal coating on like the screws and the nuts and different things like that, hoping that'll help to prevent them from rusting, which will then in turn make your unit last longer. So go ahead and remove the two little washers that are connected. Well, not connected, they're on the post. Alright, so go ahead and take your two plates and you can recycle them or dispose of them. Either one is acceptable. So then go ahead and pull out your new set of plates from the box. And you'll go ahead and place the first plate on. On the far side, away from where your wires are, is a little spring. That's just kind of to help hold it in place. Make sure that the plate is tucked in there. All you need to do is pull apart the spring a little bit and it'll provide enough space for the plate to just slide right in. Go ahead and place your washers back onto your post for the plates. So as you can see, I am now placing the nut back onto each post. Now, it's just time to screw them back down. You don't want to tighten them too tight, because if you tighten them too tight, you take the chance of breaking the ceramic part of the plate, and then you won't have any conductivity, and if you don't have any conductivity, you're not going to have any ozone. So it's just best to do them about hand tight, very, very low torque if you're using a torque driver. So, now that we have the plate secured, it's now time to go ahead and place our screws into the eye loop, so that way whenever we put them down, it makes it a little bit easier. Again, if you're using a torque driver, turn down your torque, so that way you make sure not to bust any of the ceramic parts. So now our plates have been successfully changed. Now all we need to do is, I have to turn the unit so that way I can plug it into the power. Make sure that whenever you're testing your unit, that the lid of the unit is on it to avoid any electrical shock. We don't want you to hurt yourself on accident by plugging it in thinking that you're safe, and a piece of or a little spark of electricity jumps from one of the high voltage transformers into your hand and shocks you. We don't want that to happen. So just make sure that whenever you're working on your ozone generator, the power is unplugged and the lid is on whenever you go to use it. Alright, so now that my lid is now in place, you can go ahead and plug it in just to test, just in case for some reason it was something else wrong with your unit. But go ahead and plug it back in. And then what I recommend is you look through this side over here. And if you look through this side, you can see the plates. And once you're able to see the plates and it's turned on, they'll have a nice purple glow to them. And if it's not purple all the way across, then at that point, something might be wrong with a plate, but they should have the nice glow all the way across. We don't usually have any defects with brand new plates. So go ahead and turn it on. And then as you can see, there's a nice bright purple glow inside. Now at this point, I will go ahead and I will replace the cover screws so that way my unit is fully put back together and it's in back to working condition. If you guys have any questions, comments, or if you need any answers, please leave a comment below. We'd be happy to answer any questions that you guys have, any comments, if you guys have any requests for videos. We'd be happy to make you your videos. We just need to know what you guys want to see in them. We've already made a couple YouTube videos that were user comments, so we do listen to you guys when you say you want a video for this. So if you guys tell us what you want a video for, we'll be happy to make it for you. Otherwise, you guys have a great rest of your day, and we'll see you back here next week for another video.